Hey everybody, welcome back to microbeerreviews.com. As promised, we are going to review this brand new beer from Kona Brewing Company, the Castaway Indian Pale Ale, that used to only be available on draft. I found it in this multi 12 pack, 2014 summer, called the Island Hopper Variety Pack. So it's called Castaway IPA. I've heard about this stuff. I used to travel on the West Coast. Longboard Lager was all over the place. Fire Rock Pale Ale was on draft commonly, and I'd heard this one was around. So Kona Brewing Company's been around since 1994. Most of their beers have a little bit of a flavor of Hawaii with the fruits they use. They have this really cool shaped bottle with a lot of artwork on the side of it with the islands kind of wrapped around it, but I have not ever had this beer before. It is 50 IBUs, 6.0 ABVs. It's got traditional Simcoe and Citra hops in there, and then they also have something called Galaxy and Millennium hops. I don't typically hear about those. Premium two-row pale malts, that's pretty common. They say this is a copper-rich Indian pale ale, bold taste, citrusy hops, a touch of tropical mango, and passion fruit. Passion fruit is something else that they use a lot, which is cool. Not a lot of breweries do this, so it's very sweet. But it's got a real nice kind of background to it. Balanced with rich caramel malts, has a clean, crisp finish that is refreshing as the wind in your face. Set sail for the adventure. So let's set sail. So I love it. So this is the traditional Kona Brewing Company cap with the, pop it out there, with the lizard on top. So we're looking for that nice caramel finish, but a clean, crisp, drinking beer with a fruity background to it. So looks very much like an IPA would. It's very, like they said, very clear, very crisp, nice kind of thin, white, frothy, foamy head, not too much carbonation, looks real clear. First thing I smell are hops, which is good for an IPA. Typically with their beers, I would have expected to smell the fruit first, but either way, it's here nor there. Smells good. See, that's got a little bit of a fruit, almost bite to it, which you don't typically have with an IPA. It's easy to drink, very crisp, very clean, just like what they said. It smells really different, and this is why I like Kona Brewing Company so much. They use fruits and things that a lot of other breweries don't, so it's not your traditional IPA, which some people like, some people don't. I particularly like it because it's a little bit of a change from major crazy hoppy IPA. An IPA with an IBU of only 50 is actually fairly low, which is smart because they're brewing so many different fruits in here, which has a nice little balance to it. So, one more time. Very fruity, very mango-y, very, I don't taste a lot of pineapple, but you can definitely tell there's passion fruit in there. Maybe a little bit of lemon in the background. It's really very filtered, very clean. I'm thrilled that I got to try it in this multi 12 pack. So for that reason, I'm going to up my rating just because they decided to put it in there. We rate beer between 1 and 5. I give it at least a 4. It's very good. I would definitely buy 6 packs of these if I could get my hands on them. Don't think that'll happen. But well worth the try. In the old multi 12 pack, phenomenal price point, and it's a really good kind of fruity summery IPA. So let me know what you think, if you've tried it on draft in the bottle. A lot of West Coast people like to respond on our YouTube channel, and I appreciate it very much. So let us know your thoughts on it, if you like it or you don't. As always, we upload often. We appreciate you watching, and you can follow us on Facebook and on Twitter, and we upload all the time. And